What's up, guys? This is Hot97RCT bringing you the follow-up video that I promised that I was going to do after the hardware showcase of the Magic NS for the Switch. Let me bring down the music down here. Awesome. Avenged Sevenfold, ladies and gents, if you guys didn't know. So yeah, here we are back again. We're going to be rocking, as you see, with a whole bunch of stuff going back here in the background. I hope I didn't dizzy you guys with all of the stuff that I have here. But yeah, this is essentially what I'm trying to convey for you guys here. We have, on the one hand, we have the Magic NS right around here. And I already explained to you guys what this does, the hardware side of things. If you haven't seen it yet, please go back to that video, which is the hardware showcase. And for today, also, as you can see right here in the background, is the games, which is basically what I'll be covering here today. And, you know, it's kind of like a trip back to memory lane, down memory lane with some of the games that I played the first time around that I covered for you with this controller. And as good as it was, it's not the same as playing with this puppy right here, which that little gadget allows me to do. Again, it's amazing, it's awesome, it's cheap, only 20 bucks, guys. So if you don't have the controller that you want on the Switch at this point in time, you really have no excuse. So that being said, let's go in here, and with the controller, the arcade stick, I'm going to select here, Street Fighter would be the obvious choice, but I'm not going to go with the obvious. Let's start with a shoot 'em up. Glowing Rice and both Anthony from the Neo Geo forums. Yeah, shout out to both of you guys. I'm going to go with Blazing Star. Now, the cool thing is that now that I have the arcade stick, I can actually set up all the Neo Geo games. Let me see that I don't drop it here. I can set it up with the standard layout of the Neo Geo, which is the four buttons back to back in a straight line. Not on a straight line, kind of like a semi-curved line. And I have the full, as close as possible, Neo Geo experience without actually having the system. So yeah, let's do this. Let me go into I hope you guys are enjoying what will be, at the point that you see this video, the middle of the week or midweek. I'm gonna be having, hopefully the volume set in a way to kind of compensate for the clicky clacky of the buttons, because that is something of a side effect you're gonna have if you want original hardware, you know, meaning the sandwich joysticks and stuff and buttons. They're gonna be making a lot of noise, so bear that in mind. So I'm gonna go standard fare with the first choice here. For those of you wondering what's the big deal of actually playing with the arcade stick, if you have to ask yourself that question, it's because you really don't know. You really haven't felt it. It's something that you cannot convey probably in words. It's something that you need to feel. And it's something that, aside from the obvious, the input lag that you get from using a wireless controller, let's say like the Pro controller for the Switch, It's a matter of reaction time, it's a matter of feel. You need to have that feedback, because that's the feedback that you associate with arcade. And one of the things that makes the experience more endearing. Also, there's a thing that by having this type of hardware, having the joystick, your muscle memory will not, you know, will not let you down, because your muscle memory is telling you or is looking for an association by, let's say, the layout of the buttons, which you don't get with a controller, unless you've been practicing for a long time with it. Will this make you a better player? Not exactly. I mean, if you suck in a game, you suck in a game. The best way to go about that is just practice more. But at least this will take away that kind of feeling like you're being cheated out of a chance of being better at the game, because you can respond a lot more fluidly. I said that makes for a better experience. Now, if you compare this play right here to the one I did when I covered the game when it came out, you're gonna see that the game is actually telling me that I did good, instead of telling me that I sucked like last time around. So yeah, there is a certain advantage. It's just playing more fun. Now granted, there's still going to be, at least on my side, while doing this video for you guys, there's still gonna be a little bit of lag. But that has to do not with the game or the controller. It has to do more with the fact that I'm using the way my setup is for recording this video. Just can't be helped. Jump to the next one. Let's go with a fighter. Actually, let's go with a recent one. Let's go with the Blaze Blue Crosshack battle that I just recently showcased for you guys in one of the recent videos. Always helps having cup of Java. Shout out to Afrotol, who was just a Java addict as I am. Can't wait for this one to come out. This one is coming out June 6th. Remember that date, guys. Chibi Ragna. Now hopefully the settings.
Please select your character.
The settings that I had are still there.
Ragna the Blooded. Ruby Rose. You, Narukami, hide. Get ready. Get ready.
I'm still working with the mechanics of this game. This game plays kind of a little bit like Marvel vs. Capcom and some of the other BlazBlue games.
Too bad later, just get away.
I don't pull my punches. No promises you won't get caught up in the crossfire.
Not a problem.
Anime look and voiceovers are fantastic on this game.
Can't escape from crossing fate. Fight!
Dead spike! You see this?
Persona!
Nice trip, weak! Dead spike!
Not yet!
Awesome! Everything fluid, everything where I want it to happen.
Ragna, Ruby, win!
Now, I'm expecting this game to do very well. Hopefully this will prompt Namco Bandai to actually bring Dragon Ball FighterZ to the system.
Promises away? What's it made out of? Can I hold it? Please, please!
Oh, shut up, just stop talking!
Funny stuff. So, okay, since our character selection is a little limited there, let's go jump right into the next game. Now, going to a genre outside of, let's say, fighters and shoot 'em ups, this is one of my favorite titles. Of its genre. It's kind of like the run and gun type of game. And what makes this one special is the fact that it has some really, really cool upbeat music, and everything is kind of like frantic.
Thank you.
East. Oh! Alright. Oh, don't mess up my tank yet. I need it. Yeah, it's not connecting. There you go. Got me. So yeah, shock troopers, second squad, amazing, especially with the arcade stick. So let's see, let's do Tengai. Mentioned before, a difficult game is still gonna remain a difficult game, but it's gonna be much more fun to play. Knowing that at least you have a bit more control over your character. Miko. Yeah. One of the reasons I wanted to do a follow-up video with the games is because I want to test out the range, I want to test out the stability, because it doesn't matter if, let's say, the gadget or the hardware does what it's supposed to do. The fact remains that if it's not stable and it tends to disconnect or have these kind of issues, you know, it's not really worth it. So I wanted to play a few games back to back for you guys just to demonstrate. Of course, I have both the controller and the joystick activated because it allows for that. Like I mentioned in the other video, if you haven't checked it out, check it out. I'll leave the link down below. See, it'll appear here as my primary controller is a joystick, the USB one, and then I have this one for the buttons and stuff that I might not have available on the arcade stick, because of course the arcade stick was originally designed for the Xbox 360, so it has less buttons. Now, go here in the mass wall of games. Thanks, Nintendo, for not having a folder system out yet. Let's go in Samurai Showdown 4. Since Hamster still hasn't wanted to release Samurai Showdown 5 special, Hamster. But now, with the news of the Neo Geo Mini, Anthony, you can, you know, roll with that. One of the titles there is a Samurai Showdown 5 special, so yes, I am going to pre-order. Yes, I need that little system. Any system that gives priority to my favorite title on the Neo Geo needs to be purchased. Okay. Oh, no. Wait. There you go. No. It's getting the wrong place here. Okay. Drop the quata. Music to my ears, both the sounds of the game and the sound of the joystick and buttons. Yes. Ooh. Haumaru. Yes.
Iza jinjō ni ippon me.
So sorry for your ass. You might be sick and everything, but I'm not gonna concede.
Oh,
missed my chance for the special command. Oh well.
いざ尋常に 1本目
So yeah, the fluidity is there. Got him. Got him. Fatality, baby. Oh, yeah. That was sweet. That was so sweet. All right, guys. That's going to be... I'm going to end on that high note. Doing that nice little special command at the end is a great way to show off how really good the little device is, you know, Magic NS. That was the point of these two videos. I hope that you enjoyed them and got the information, of course, needed from them. That's going to be all for now. I didn't want to go through all of the games because it would make the video super, super long and kind of boring for you guys, seeing the same games that I already covered. But you got an idea. It works. It actually works, and it works great. So if you're like me, a fan of the arcade experience, fully having a faithful rendition of the game plus the interface that you need for it, then, and you're a fan of the Switch, of course. If you don't have a Switch, this really doesn't matter. This thing works both for the PC and for the Switch, and is a godsend, at least until we get more variety of arcade sticks, Sanwa, and, you know, tournament grade sticks available for the system. So that's going to be all for now, guys. I hope you enjoyed. Please like and sub, and more importantly, share, so it gets my videos out there. That's the whole point. So thanks a lot, guys. Thanks for the support. Shout out to AfroSoul, Growing Rice, and Anthony from the Neo Geo forums, Aaron Classic Gamer, who actually, by the way, we have talked back and forth, and he is an arcade freak just like me. So yeah, that'll be all for now. Check you guys soon. Peace.